Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jessica and today I'm back with another Brandy Melville Thrift Flip. Before getting into the video, I want to thank you guys for 500 subscribers. I know I haven't posted in a while. I had so many videos filmed and ready to edit, but my dumbass broke my SD card, so I lost all the footage. But I finally got a new SD card, so I'm going to be posting more often for you guys. Anyways, let's get into the video. First piece I'm flipping is this purple tee. This isn't the exact one I'm flipping because I lost the footage of me trying that one on, but you get the idea. I'm going to be turning this top into the Gina top. First, I am cutting off the hemmed collar to make it a wider V. Next, I am cropping the bottom of the tee to my desired length. And also cutting the sides of the shirt and the underarm part of the sleeve to make sure the shirt is fitted. Now setting that off to the side, I am taking the cropped piece of fabric and cutting out a 1-inch wide strip. Next, I cut the loop to make it one long strip, and I'm using it to hem the collar of the shirt. To do this, I am pinning the front side of the strip to the front side of the shirt. Then using a back stitch, I am sewing all around the collar. I have shown this stitch in many of my other videos, but I also linked tutorials on all the stitches I used in this video. Next, I sewed the V part of the collar by pinning the front sides together and used a back stitch. Now I am folding the strip of fabric around the collar and pinning it down to create a hem. Then sewing around again with a backstitch. And once I finished, I tied it off and cut off any excess material. Next, turning the shirt inside out, I am taking a thin piece of elastic and cutting a 3.5-inch piece that I am pinning to the center of the shirt. This is what's going to create the ruche. And then to sew this, I am using a backstitch. But every time I stitch, I stretch the elastic so that the elastic is stitched over more fabric. Hopefully that made sense. Anyways, you want to make sure to stretch with even tension so the ruching is even. After that, I flip the shirt right side out and I am cutting the top piece of fabric that creates the seam that runs under the chest area. To create the seam, I am pinning the front sides together and sewing it using a backstitch. You see her walking down the boulevard. She got the posture of a superstar. She looks so fly in those Gucci slides. Yeah, yeah, I wonder where she hides under her disguise. Yeah, 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 yeah. And once that's done, the front side of the shirt will have that W scoop design. And then the last thing to do is close the sides and hem the bottom of the top. Like before, I pinned the sides and the bottom of the shirt and sewed it using a backstitch. And there's the completed top. This looks very similar to the Brandy Gina top, and the shirt was only $3 from the thrift store. Alright, the next shirt I'm working with is this plain white tank top. For this top, I decided to recreate the Daisy Skylar tank. First, I cropped the shirt to my desired length. And then I hemmed it by pinning and stitching using a backstitch. Now I'm thinking of Now moving on to the embroidery, I am first marking the middle of the shirt and then 4.5 centimeters from each side. Then I use a sewing pin to mark where the design is going to be. Next, I measure 3.5 centimeters down from the underarm of the shirt, and I use this to mark where the stems of the daisies will start. For the embroidery, I am using my regular thread in this light green, yellow, and pink color. Starting with the stem, I am using a backstitch to sew 2 centimeters upwards between 2 of the ribs of the shirt. My shirt is kind of ribbed, so it makes it easier for my lines to stay straight and the width to stay the same. Once that was done, I moved on to the leaves. For this, I used the same stitch, but I sewed in a slight upward diagonal. You want to start with smaller stitches and get wider towards the middle, and then get smaller towards the end of the leaf. At the very end, you want to pull very tightly on the thread to sharpen the tip of the leaf. Now I repeated the same thing on the other side of the stem. Once that was done, I moved on to the yellow center of the flower. Using the same stitch, I'm creating a semicircular center. The ends have a smaller stitch, and towards the middle, you want to get wider. Another tip is to tug on the ends to round it out before tying it off and cutting the thread. Lastly, I'm stitching the 7 petals around the center of the flower. Using the pink thread, I'm stitching the petals the same way as the leaves on the stem. Once I finished one, I repeated it 6 more times and the first flower was complete. I did this 2 more times, and there's the completed top. This was my first time embroidering, so I'm very proud of how this top turned out, and it was actually very easy to make. Okay, next I have a little bonus before the next top. So I am taking the crop piece of fabric from the tank, and I'm using it to make a headband. First, I cut off the hem bottom. Then I cut the fabric to double the width I want it to be. And then after that, I cut it to the length that fits my head. Next, I opened up the strip of fabric and I folded the front sides together. Next, I pinned and sewed down the whole length of the headband using a backstitch. Then I flipped the headband right side out. And I pinned and sewed one side of the ends together. For the other side, I had to create a flap on each side, which would be sewn together. To do this, I'm using a ladder stitch. Basically, I am sewing back and forth through the flaps, which creates a ladder pattern. Once that is finished, when you pull the thread, the 2 flaps seal together, and you won't be able to see the stitching. After adjusting, I cut the thread, and there's the finished simple white headband. Okay, moving on to the last piece. I'm flipping this plain white v-neck tee, and I'm turning it into the Ray wrap top. First, I crop the shirt. Make sure to crop it 5 centimeters more than the length you want. Next, I cut straight down the middle of the shirt, and I opened it up. Then, on the back piece of the shirt, I drew a line 5 centimeters above the bottom of the shirt. From that point, I connected the corner of the front of the shirt to create a diagonal line. Next, I cut along all the lines, and I closed the shirt. Now, from the corners of the shirt, I'm cutting diagonally to the top of the collar and around the collar to connect the sides together. Once that's done, I set it off to the side. Next, taking the crop piece of fabric, I first cut off the hem bottom. And then cut 2 thinner strips and 2 wider strips. First, taking the thinner strips, I'm cutting the loop and attaching their front sides together to create 1 long strip. Then I'm using it to hem all around the shirt. I'm doing the same thing as the first shirt, where I'm pinning and stitching the strip of fabric around the shirt. Then I am folding the strip down to create a hem and sewing around the shirt one more time. Once that was done, I tied it off and cut off any excess material. Now moving on to the thicker strips of fabric, I cut the loop and pinned and sewed the two front sides and one of the ends together. This is going to be used for the two ties. After that, I used the open end to flip the strip right side out. Now taking the two strips, I am attaching their front sides to the corners of the shirt. Once that was done, the tie top was finished. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. This top is very cute and very similar to the Brandy top. If I had more fabric, I would have made the ties wider, but this still works. And that's the end of the video. Hopefully this inspires you to turn some of your own clothes into Brandy pieces. I also have a part one to this video, so you can go ahead and check that out. And also, comment down below if there's any other pieces you would like me to recreate. But anyways, if you guys like this video, please give it a like. And if you like me, then subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.